Hi, I'm Terry Scott Mitchell, and I'm pleased to be here today at the Tuskegee Airmen Scholarship Foundation Gold Medal Gala.
The expectations placed upon you men are high.
We have a right to fight for our country, the same as every other American.
I'm the best pilot in the whole damn army.
Only one way to find out.
We're giving hand-me-down planes.
We're losing them!
Feel like I'm flying my grandfather's Buick.
Hoping that we would just limp along and go away. We will not go away.
Hi, I'm Terry Scott Mitchell, and it's been a beautiful evening here with the Tuskegee Airmen Scholarship Foundation Gold Medal Gala. I'm privileged to be standing next to Theodore Lumpkin, we affectionately call him Ted, who's also on the board of directors for the Scholarship Foundation. Ted, thank you so much for being here. Tell us what it means to you.
It means quite a bit to see a big gala like this. Reminds me of the olden days when we used to have the big ones at the Hilton Hotel, Beverly Hilton. And to see everyone so happy and pleased and pleasant and a nice, well-organized program, it was very, very nice. And I had quite a few guests, and they all enjoyed it. So it was a privilege.
Yes, Ted, what was one of the fondest memories you have of being a Tuskegee Airman? I know that's a long question, but
yeah,
can you pick out one little
question.
Thing?
Well,
Ramanelli, what?
Yeah, at Ramatelli. And I think the event where those bomber pilots had to land at our Air Force base because of bad weather. And at that time, they found out that we were red tails, and we're black, and... And so we had 5 days they were there at our base, and they got to know us, and we got to know them, and it really helped.
We got treated by the Germans better than we got treated by the people at home.
After the war was over, we've actually had some of our youngsters actually ask us and said, Mr. Jefferson, after the war was over, you were called nigger and you were called boy. Why didn't you rise up and why didn't you sit in? But you see, we had a job to do, which was to come home and to raise another generation. And if you will understand something, if you know history, who are the black youngsters who caused the sit-ins in the 60s? They were our children.
Hi, I'm here with Winnie Jackson, who is an advocate for children and does a tremendous amount of work, even though she's retired. Winnie, share with us a little bit about your latest project.
Well, what I'm doing is I'm introducing children to the space shuttle and to the subjects of math and science. So with the coming of the Endeavor, which is already here, it will begin its journey to the California Science Center on October 12th and 13th. So I have two things in mind. First, to have the children see it while it travels, and then on December 15th, I want to have over 1,000 children out to experience the day with the Tuskegee Airmen. It's connecting the past with the present, with the future. Because we have some of the Tuskegee Airmen that worked on the shuttle, and the children will be able to understand their heritage by listening to what the Tuskegee Airmen have to say. They will appreciate the shuttle more because they actually worked on it, and encouraging them to look at the subjects of math and science, especially when I had a chance to see the film tonight and notice that there were not minority children
exactly
in that mixture.
Right. How did you enjoy the event tonight? What did it mean
this
to you?
This was the most amazing, I have no words for it, because again, I walked in the middle of history. You did an excellent job. Because of everything that was on the screen, it is a documentation of the contributions that have been made. It is very, very relevant and very needed today for our young people, because they've lost that connection.
Exactly.
They've lost the history. And when you have living history, when it's living,
still,
it means so much more, because they can speak to the children can speak to them and speak to us. And when I see them being a descendant of slaves, understanding what they had to go through, being born in Texas, I remember everything. I haven't forgotten a thing.
Exactly.
And I felt that what you did today was, tonight rather, it was well put together, because even from the honorees that you chose, which is our future,
exactly.
America's adventure into space, mm-hmm. it also brought into view, again, what these men have done in speaking into the lives and to the future that we have, or if we're going to have it.
We are going to have it.
You know what? It also reminds us not only of the fight, but when you see something coming again mm-hmm. that they've already experienced, it makes you very wary.
Exactly.
Makes you very cautious. Mm-hmm. And it should put you in gear to say that will never happen again.
And that we need to take action.
That's right.
Thank you
That's
so right. much, Winnie, for being present and joining us at the Tuskegee Airmen Scholarship Foundation Gold Medal Gala.
I'm so happy to be here.
Parachute deploy around Mach 1.7. Parachute is deployed. Touchdown confirmed. We're safe on Mars.
Hi, I'm Terry Scott Mitchell, and I'm here with President of Caltech, Dr. Jean-Louis Chameau. Doctor, tell us why you were able to come here today, and we appreciate first and foremost your participation, and we'd like to know why is it so important for a Caltech president to make a donation or be part of such a prestigious event?
It's an honor for me to be part of such an event. You know, Caltech is a university. We are dedicated to young people. We educate extraordinary young students, and we need to support them. And programs like this one, which is supporting young people, providing them scholarship, is very important, not only to Caltech, but to the nation as a whole.
D'accord, merci. And also, how long have you been in the États-Unis, in the United States?
Oh, I have been in the U.S. for more than 30 years. I came for 1 year to be a graduate student at Stanford. I was sure it would be 1 year, one became two, and life happens. And I'm very pleased to be here more than 30 years later.
D'accord. Well, we really appreciate your participation. And enchanté, monsieur.
Merci beaucoup.
Hi, I'm Terry Scott Mitchell, and I'm here with Jacqueline Moscoso. She's the 2010 scholarship recipient. Jacqueline, what has this scholarship meant to you?
This scholarship has allowed me to be able to look out for myself. It has let me be able to take care of my own actions, and in the sense that I could apply for other scholarships of my own and let that struggle for paying for college be off of my parents' back.
And what do you want to do when you complete your education? What are you studying now, and what do you want to do when you grow up?
Currently, I'm a biology major. I'm hoping for pre-med, and I want to become a doctor later on in the Department of Pediatrics or OBGYN.
Absolutely fabulous. These are the kind of students that we look forward to promoting and contributing to their legacy. And also, what is the scholarship in terms of the Tuskegee Airmen? What does that mean to you?
It just means hope, that there's hope out there, and that it has allowed for inspiration in my life.
Absolutely wonderful. Thank you so much, Jacqueline.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Terry Scott Mitchell, and I'm here with Major General Charles Bolden, one of our major people here and major contributors, and we're also honoring him today with the Jimmy Doolittle Award. Thank you so much for being present. It's an honor to be in your presence, and I know you're also one of the Mumford Marines.
Thank you very much for being here. It's an honor for me to be here as an honorary Tuskegee Airman from many years back, and as a member of the Mumford Point Marine Association, sort of a sister organization to the Tuskegee Airmen. But I'm especially honored to be recognized by this organization for their inaugural Jimmy Doolittle Award. And I'm honored also by the co-honorees tonight, Elon Musk and Dr. Chameau, who is a very good friend and co-worker, actually, from Caltech, since Caltech runs the jet propulsion labs for NASA. So
exactly.
We work together quite a bit.
Now, I thought you were retired, but you're back in government. So what's that all about?
I flunked retirement. Yeah, that's what it's about. I retired after 34 years in the Marine Corps. And in the middle of that time, 14 years I had spent in the astronaut office. So I come from two cultures, and I was blessed when President Obama finally decided to ask me to at least accept the nomination to be the NASA administrator, and I went through Senate confirmation and became the 12th administrator of NASA. So I've been there through the last 3 years of the administration.
Wonderful.
And loving it.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
And are you the first African-American to hold this slot?
I am. Although, I love to give credit to another Tuskegee Airman,
okay.
Colonel Fred Gregory, U.S. Air Force retired, who is a former astronaut and was actually the deputy administrator at NASA for a number of years with Dan Golden. And for a short period of time, he served as the acting NASA administrator. So,
excellent.
Not confirmed, but okay. I count it.
Exactly.
Yeah,
right.
So I'm the second, and I followed him as the second pilot astronaut of color.
Excellent.
So,
excellent.
Yeah.
Well, we're here with pure excellence tonight, and I just want to thank Charlie, as we're going to call him from here on in, for being part of it and allowing us to honor him. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Good to be here with you. Thank you.
Major General Charles Bolden, as the recipient of the first General James H. Jimmy Doolittle Memorial Award, reflects in his outstanding military service and expert management as NASA administrator the outstanding qualities of leadership that General Doolittle practiced in all aspects of his very full and meaningful life. We are honored to present the Doolittle Memorial Award to Major General Charles H. Bolden, Jr. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the General.
And if you looked at the control center, it was relatively diverse, with one exception. People of color. And Charles Alachi knows where I'm coming from because he and I have battled as cohorts. NASA is an absolutely incredible organization, and I think we lead government organizations in striving for diversity, but we're not there yet. And I think what the Tuskegee Airmen did, and I'm going to take personal privilege to comment on another organization that's represented here, not only by me, but by others, the Montford Point Marines. And the Montford Point Marine Association is an organization very much like Tuskegee Airmen that represents the almost 19,000 young men of color, black men, who went to a place called Montford Point Camp in 1942, at the same time that young black men were going to Moton Field in Tuskegee, Alabama, to fight for the right to fight for this country. And tonight, we need to remember that. They fought for the right to fight for this country. I am here today because of a lot of people.
I remember a pilot friend of mine saying, America's not perfect, but I'll hold her hand until she gets well.
We are absolutely honored to be at the Tuskegee Airmen Scholarship Foundation's Gold Medal Gala. See you next time. Bye-bye.